Hey everyone, it's Katie from Bobby Hair Studio. Welcome back, and if this is your first time, then welcome to our page. I've created this YouTube channel to help new stylists figure out kind of the more difficult and advanced ways of doing hair so that they don't have to practice and learn by trial and error on their own clients. So here today is a color correction that I did. I'm taking this client who has pink and purple and blue in her blonde hair, and we're actually bringing her down to something more natural to try to suit her natural root as much as possible. So if you want to see my tutorial and formula on how I turned this today into this in one appointment, then keep watching and remember to follow us on Instagram at Bobby Hair Studio and my own personal Instagram at vancity.blonde if you want to support us for free in more ways. And remember to like and subscribe and turn on the notification bells for future videos. So let's get started, and we're gonna talk a little bit about how this kind of process is before we go into the formulas. If you took a look at my client's natural root color, she's somewhere around a level 6. And if you've been doing hair, you know that it's extremely difficult to actually match someone's natural root color when you're trying to color down someone's hair. You can get kind of close, but the exact tones of it are almost never able to be replicated entirely, so we're going for as close of a blend as possible so that she can just go super low maintenance with her hair and not have to worry about coming in every 10 weeks for new foils. This process isn't just a full color. We're doing a color down with fills because her hair has blonde in it, pink in it, blue in it, and purple in it. So that means that there's porosity issues all over the place. Plus she has a decent amount of her natural root. So this isn't actually, this is a very difficult process to formulate because there's so much going on with the hair. It's not as easy as it looks. If you formulate it too light, then you can still see the pink and purple and blue underneath. If you formulate it too dark, she suddenly has light roots and black looking ends because porous ends tend to suck up all the dark color and ashy colors really quickly and over process them and make them look super, super dark. So this is pretty advanced, and I'm really happy to share my formulas with you guys if you continue watching. This is a chart of underlying pigments, and it's essentially a chart to show what the natural level is in the hair, and then below it is the color that's underlying. When you lift away a little bit of that melanin in their natural hair, that's the color you're going to see underneath. This is a big helper because when you look at the level 6, it says orange underneath of it. So I know that orange is going to be the main part of my fill formula. And in your fills, you can always add in some other colors depending on what you need in the hair, but orange is going to be the main color that you're going to put into this fill so that the next colors that you put in that are her natural colors and the ash tones, that they get held in. If you try to fill someone with only cool tones, you will get a muddy, patchy, ugly result, and those colors won't look good in the hair. One of the reasons why we fill with warm colors like red, orange, and yellow is because they have large molecules and they stay in the hair shaft longer. And what they also do is they attach themselves to smaller molecules like the greens, blues, and purples that are neutralizing colors. So you need a balance of warm and cool to return to something that's slightly natural looking in someone's hair. You can't go with only cool tones. That's where you're gonna end up with green, mossy ass looking hair. Because she's a level 6, I'm mixing together a 5-7 and a 7-57. I'm mixing a 5 and a 7 together to bring it together and create a level 6. And these two colors that are in these toners are orange and gold colors. So these are fill colors, and her hair is going to be quite coppery once this has sat into her hair, but that's exactly what I'm looking for because that's going to hold in all the ash tones that I put in next. So even though this looks scary, trust me, it's what we want. I didn't show my developer, but what I've mixed this with is the 6-volume gel because I don't want to see any lift and I don't want to deposit darker than her natural hair because that's going to affect her natural root and it's going to look so much darker. This is the thing that you need to worry about when you're doing fills, is that you need to almost formulate for a slightly lighter than their natural color because worst case scenario, you can always dye it darker again. Since she's processed for the full time and then been rinsed out and towel dried, now we're gonna put in 6-63. And what this is it's a chocolate matte. and the three in an Agora Vibrance line is a green color. So I'm actually mixing together reds, browns, greens on top of the orange and yellow. And what the green is gonna do is it's going to cool down those orange, yellow, and red tones and bring it slightly more neutral, because this is a very coppery color. And again, this is how we neutralize that, but still keep the color looking like a nice, rich, healthy brown. All of my toners and fills are being processed for their full time, and you can see already that her color has been cooled down significantly. And now we're ready to go in with our full color over. We have enough warmth in there. Now our next color is going to be formulated with natural tones and ash tones only. I'm mixing together TBH 6-06, which is a natural chocolate color in their more demi-permanent line, with a semi-permanent 5-21, which is an ash cendré. So I've got like navy and blue and chocolate brown all in this formula together. And I know it's a no-no to cross-mix color lines, but honestly, I really like it for when I'm going from light to dark, because it just has that extra bit of power and hold into the color, so it doesn't rinse out so fast. And this all got mixed together with the Agora Vibrance 6-Volume Gel Developer. Again, this provides no lift. It's going to have a tiny bit of deposit in her root, but again, you guys have seen the end result. It is so beautiful and shiny. It is covered so well, and the porosity has been evened out. You can tell there's a little bit of a color difference between her natural and what's not natural, but honestly, at a quick glance, you're not gonna tell that this person has had color work done to their hair. It looks pretty natural and very rich and shiny. So we're really happy with this result. What do you guys think? Let me know in the comments below. Thanks, guys. Remember to follow us online.